No need for the air conditioner to work. The fans are all turned off. SubhanAllah. Beautiful weather. We had this beautiful month of Ramadan, in which pleasant weather as well. And we had gone through a number of beautiful topics, and I'm sure that Sheikh Abdul Qadir, the Imam who conducted Jumu'ah for the past 3 weeks, alhamdulillah, he also did an excellent job. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward him as well, and all of us, inshallah. Ameen. Over the Ramadan, especially after the Taraweeh, we have visited a number of historical events that took place in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the Sahaba, especially Ghazwatu Badr, the Battle of Badr. We also had a number of evenings we spent on the story of Fatih Mecca. Fatih Mecca, subhanAllah. Now, inshallah, I'm thinking of, inshallah, visiting Surah Ikhlaas, because I remember before Ramadan, we had attempted to cover the verses from Surah Al-Fatiha. It took a few weeks. Now, inshallah, we'll now try to understand Surah Al-Ikhlas so that when we are praying our salah, we will appreciate it and we'll have better focus. Surah Al-Ikhlas is one of the most important surahs in the Quran, because that covers third part of the Quran. SubhanAllah, Surah Al-Ikhlas, though it is very short and sweet, that not sometimes like the chili that uncle brings to me, as small as it is, hot is it. Like that, this surah, this is the miracle, mercy of the Quran. Some of the shortest surah, which is Surah Al-Kawthar, that gave the biggest headache to the Makkahs. And you know, it was full of warning and, you know, scolding, and it was also, you know, answering their accusations. It was amazing. And it was a big challenge. With using that one line of surah, which is only three ayat, it continued, repeatedly challenged the people of Mecca. So that the shortest surah that we have, at least to bring that one line equal, you know, to match with the Quran, and they failed it. So that small, very small surah, the smallest one, the shortest one, gave the biggest headache to the kuffar. And it continues until the Yawm al-Qiyamah. It doesn't stop that. And for us, for the believers, for those who got iman, subhanAllah, it increases in our iman. Surah al-Ikhlas is of one of that kind, because Surah al-Ikhlas, the Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that it is equal to one third of the Quran. Or if you read Surah Al-Ikhlas, you have read one third of the Quran, you get the reward for that. The reason being, my lovely believers, that Surah Al-Ikhlas, the Quran, when you look at it, it can be classified, it can be categorized into three parts. One extensively deals with ahkam, the rules of it. The other one deals with asma wa sifat, the names and the qualities of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In fact, Surah Al-Ikhlas is all about tawheed, all about the names and qualities of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If someone asks us, what is the definition of tawheed? And what is the definition of shirk based on the Quran? The best definition that we can read out is Surah Al-Ikhlas. The moment, what is tawheed? The tawheed is قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ اللَّهُ الصَّمَدْ لَمْ يَلِدْ وَلَمْ يُولَدْ وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدْ. It covered everything that we want me to learn about tawheed, subhanAllah. So the surah itself is such a powerful surah. I just want to tell you that Habibuna sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that, you know, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam heard someone reading Surah Al-Ikhlas repeatedly, Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said the word wajabat. Wajabat. A number of times he used, there was another time that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used the word wajabat. I don't know if I have time. That when a janaza was being carried, or when a janaza was being done, people started praising that person of that janaza. That man was such a lovely person in these days. When people started praising sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he made this comment of wajabat. Wajabat. You know, remember that we said as wajib? Salatul witr wajib. Like that, wajib. So the fi'l madi, the past tense of that wajib is wajibat. So the Prophet said that wajibat. And then later, after a few days or some days later, another person's janazah was done, then people started talking negative. people said something negative about it, the Prophet ﷺ made another comment, the same comment of wajibat. So the Sahaba, they thought this is something we really need to find out what the Habib ﷺ meant by wajibat. So they asked, Ya Rasulullah, we heard this very odd, very strange comment from you saying that wajibat. Wajibat means it would happen, which is compulsory. It is essential to happen. That is the actual meaning of it. Now, Arabic is very powerful. It's just one small word, wajibat, but the meaning I can't give you. I don't know what meaning can be. Is there any other meaning you can get? The only meaning, it is essential to happen. That's the meaning I can get. Anyway, so the Prophet said, when he was asked, he said, when you praise the first person, the man of that first janazah, you said so many great things. He's a pious man, he's a salih, he's this and that. Then that means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala heard you, what you said, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given him, or the Jannah is wajib for him. The Jannah is essential for him. That's why it is really important, when we talk about those who passed away, do not focus on their negative things, even if there is any. Even if they have done something to you or whatever, do not highlight, even talk about negative things. Try to praise. Think and talk about the good things, you know, positive side of the people. Alhamdulillah, we do have that that culture, that practice. That's great. So the second person, about him, when people started talking negative things, remember the believers, you know, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes our word very seriously. When the Muslims say, when we say believers say that, remember that, وَكَذَلِكَ جَعَلْنَاكُمْ أُمَّةً وَسَطًا لِتَكُونُوا شُهَدَاءَ عَلَى النَّاسِ. We are the witnesses, you know, about people. We give witnesses. So when we give witness that so-and-so is a bad guy, remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is listening. So be really careful about that. Don't harm people like that. So the Prophet said wajibat. Anyway, so wajibat here, the Prophet said when he heard that, I don't want to visit that, but just came because of this wajib that came up here. So the Prophet, when he heard this brother, this Sahabi reading Surah Al-Ikhlas many times, he said wajib. Then the Sahab asked, Ya Rasulullah, again we heard you say wajib, what does that mean? So the Prophet said, wajib lahu al-jannah. The jannah is master for that person because he loves Surah Al-Ikhlas, he reads it. Another time, there was a big issue. This I want you to pay attention to, okay? Now, the big issue was that there was an imam in the Masjid al-Quba. Masjid al-Quba is the first masjid to be built by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Okay, even before Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam built Masjid al-Nabawi, he had built what? Masjid al-Quba. As he arrived after migration, the first first station was Masjid al-Quba, and he built a masjid there called Masjid. So in Masjid al-Quba, he sallallahu alaihi wasallam had appointed a Sahabi to lead the salah. Because the Prophet was leading Salah in Masjid al-Nabawi, so someone was actually leading Salah there. Now this imam, he actually was doing something very odd and strange. What was that? He would read Surah al-Fatiha, and in every Salah, what he does is that he would read Surah al-Fatiha, and then he would read Surah al-Ikhlas, and then he would read another Surah. Okay? So every Surah, just like Surah al-Fatiha, will be reading Surah al-Ikhlas as well. So the people, you know how the people have, you know, if they love to pick on whom? Not only the Muqtadis, they love to pick on the Imam. So that's been like that, isn't it, traditionally. But it's okay, but you've got to be careful. Okay, with the respect and nicely, there's nothing wrong, alhamdulillah, I love that, you know. Some brothers, they come and bring up, you know, and bring it to our notice, some of our mistakes. Who else will tell us? Alhamdulillah, the right people should say. But just, don't hurt anyone, okay? So anyway, so the Sahaba, some of them, they went to him and said, Imam Sahib, that's my language, but not their language. Imam Sahib, that you read in every rak'ah you read Surah Al-Ikhlas. Okay, we don't understand why. And on top of it, right after Surah Al-Ikhlas, you also read what? Another surah. Tell us what is going on. You better stop it, Imam. Please, next time you only read a surah after Surah Al-Fatiha, and not just repeating all the times in Surah Al-Ikhlas. Then he said, nah. No choice. If you want me to lead Salah, I'm going to continue this way. No, I'm not going to change. Otherwise, I can stop. Then they said, okay, no problem. We'll go to Medina. We'll go to the Masjid Nabawi, and we'll talk to him. Big case, isn't it? Case against the Imam. So they went to the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and they said, Ya Rasulullah, there's a big issue. The issue is that our Imam, he's doing something that we never seen you doing it.
In today's world, we'll say, well, bid'ah. Okay, we see that he was doing something odd on his own. And why is that? So they made a big case against the Imam. So the Prophet is the wisest person. Called this Imam and said, you tell me, why is that? Tell us, why are you reading Surah Al-Ikhlas? He said, because I love Surah Al-Ikhlas. Finished. And the Prophet said, if you love Surah Al-Ikhlas, that is the reason. If that is the reason and you think that it is worth reading and everything, you know, that if you love that Surah Al-Ikhlas, go with it because that will give you Jannah. Subhanallah. No more, you know, discussion. He was, you know, approved. You know, it was a big victory. So what is that all about? Love Surah Al-Ikhlas. At least read 10 Surah Al-Ikhlas every day. I just forgot the other piece of that hadith. You know, forgetting. قَاتَبَ اللَّهُ نَسِيًا. That 10 times of Surah Al-Ikhlas, at least every day read it, inshallah. It will be great, inshallah. It will be leading us to Jannat al-Firdaus. What is this Surah Al-Ikhlas? Surah Al-Ikhlas is so important because it's about Ikhlas itself. What does Ikhlas mean? Before we go into the surah itself, the name itself we need to analyze. What is Ikhlas? Ikhlas is, in English we can say sincerity. Okay, showing our sincerity or doing any act only for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Which is the most difficult part actually. Alright, because we all tend to, when we give out something or when we say something, when we read something, we all have a kind of, you know, tendency to involve people in. But it's a major problem. It's a major sin. Got to be careful. It is, the Prophet has described it to that showing of as a shirk al-asghar, the minor shirk, minor associated partner, the opposite of ikhlas, showing or doing something for the sake of people. I do not want to go to this extreme, but I just want to share with you how some of the scholars termed it about our practice. It's not recommended for anyone, but one item said that عَمَلُ لِأَجْلِ النَّاسِ شِرْكٌ تَرْكُهُ لِلنَّاسِ ذَاكَ هُوَ الْيَاءُ صَبَحْ لَلَهُ. And then he said that إِمَانُ مَرْءٍ لَا يَكُونُ تَكَامُلًا حَتَّى يَرَانَا سَنْبِكِ مِلٍ مُثِلًا. If the faith of a person will not be completed until he regards other people just like camels. Well, that's really rude. You look at other people like camels. That's all right. That's why I said you've got to be careful before you listen to this one. Disclaimer. So what does that mean is that when you pray a salah, suppose that you've got a camel right next to you. You will not try to bring some quality in your salah because the camel is watching you. Let me just say, Bismillah. Improve my salah because the camel is watching me. Camel is right next to me, so let me do my rukur very properly. Sujood very properly. Stay a little bit longer in sujood because the camel is watching. We'll never do that. Because you know that camel has got nothing to do with your salah. Camel is not going to do that. No. He's not going to say that. Oh, because you've been praying very well, please come and sit comfortably. No. That won't happen. Just like that, bi'imri muthila, that when you are praying and you think that the people around you, maybe you're praying, you're reading the surah loud or soft or whatever, they have nothing to do with your salah. They have nothing, no share at all. You're doing for the sake of Allah. Whatever the beauty, jamalia that you bring in the surah, in the reading, in the sujood and everything, keep it only for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everyone else, when it comes to the share of your salah, just like other camels, they got nothing. They don't have anything to do. There's some exception for the imams, by the way. That is, you can't give, you know, some imams, they, you know, maybe myself, they read that in a way that people just run away. Okay? That they should do. Imams should try their best, their level best, to read in a beautiful way so that the people appreciate. Surah Al-Ikhlas, it's all about Ikhlas. Mukhlisina lahuddin teaches us that we should worship only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When I was talking about this Ikhlas, I can tell you to what extent the Sahaba were concerned about their Ikhlas. Sayyidina Hamzah radiyallahu anhu. Sayyidina Hamzah radiyallahu anhu, one of the great Sahabi. One day he started, you know, in today's language we'll say he lost his mind. That means he was so worried and depressed. And then Abu Bakr radiyallahu anhu passed and he greeted him, said, and he was, what's wrong with you, Hamzah? You look so depressed today. What is everything okay? I said, no, Abu Bakr, no. Today I'm really worried. What happened? Nafaqa hanzala. Nafaqa hanzala. Hanzala has become a hypocrite. I'm a hypocrite now. I'm a hypocrite. I have gone a hypocrite. Nafaqa hanzala. So Abu Bakr said, what are you talking about? How can you say that you have you're a believer? You're a believer, you're a mu'min. How can you say that? He said, Abu Bakr, think about it. Yesterday and every day, we will go and sit next to the Prophet and we listen to his beautiful speech about the Jannah, Jahannam, about all these things. SubhanAllah, so amazing to hear that. And we like, you know, nothing would, we'll say that we got to be just dedicating to pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, worship him alone. You know, we take that kind of, such a powerful speech that we hear and all completely changed. But in that, after that we come home, and then we sit with our families, our children, we're back to normal dunya, and our dunya is coming up terrible under the pressure. That's a hypocrisy, that's not ikhlas. That's not ikhlas. So what is happening? Then Abu Bakr said, oh, that's a good plan. You're not the only one, I'm also in the same. Abu Bakr is saying that I'm also in the same position. So we need to find a solution. I don't have any solution. We can go to God, the best person who can give us a solution is the Harim Sallallahu. How lucky they are. Any problem goes to him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. No dispute, no argument. So both of them went to the Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Big trouble there. Nafaqa said he's gone hypocrite. And his point is valid. What he's saying is true. That I also feel the same thing. That when we sit in front of Ya Rasulullah, our spiritually we gone. You know, our iman, taqwa, khawf, everything gone so high. You know, maximum. But once we leave, you know, we start to light. So the Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, he says, Allah, he said, if you continue like that, the way that you were in front of me and listening and all this, your spirit, your iman, your taqwa is so high, you know, and they continue to be like that forever, then the malaika, the angels will come and do shake hand. They will do musafaha with you. But Abu Bakr and Muhammad, listen, sa'ah wa sa'ah. Sometimes you'll have, you know, that full khawf and fear only Allah. Sometimes, you know, a little bit of dunya, that's all normal, natural, don't worry about it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us ikhlas, inshallah, surah al-ikhlas. We'll continue with that one, inshallah. Akhu da'wana, alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah, inshallah, after salah.